Shepard, some luck. Original strain in storage. Preparing the cure now.
Make it quick, Morton. They're all over us out here.
Holy shit! Off to the left!
Systems are intact.
I just got shot by a rig.
Consider that practice.
Okay, Shepard. I raised the hammers. You have to activate both of them. My advice is avoid the giant laser.
You've got to be kidding!
If I was organic, that would probably burn!
Just keep moving! Stick to cover!
I don't think cover's gonna do the trick!
Thank you. Yes, loaded for dispersal in 2 minutes. Procedure traumatic for Eve, but not lethal. Malin's research invaluable.
She's okay?
Headed to safety now. Her survival fortunate. We'll stabilize new government should Rex get any ideas. Good match. Promising future for Krogan.
Gale!
Control room at top of Shroud Tower. Must take elevator up.
You're going up there?
Yes. Readings at lab suggest temperature malfunction. Could affect cure viability. Need to adjust settings manually.
It's too dangerous, Morton. We need to get out of here.
No. Temperature variance could destroy cure. Time running out. Have to go up.
Morton, you're not going up.
Not concerned for my safety. Concerned I might discover something. Sabotage? But whose? Ah. Why, Shepard? That desperate for Salarian aid? Or that afraid of Krogan?
Every time we've talked about this before, you've defended the Genophage. Hell, I had to talk you into saving Malin's data. How can you change your mind now?
I made a mistake! I made a mistake. Focused on big picture. Big picture made of little pictures. Too many variables. Can't hide behind statistics. Can't ignore new data. My responsibility. Need to go. Running out of time.
Morton. Walk away.
Can't do that, Shepard.
I don't have a choice here. Walk away, or I will fire.
Not your decision. Not your work. Not your cure. Had to be me. Someone else might have gotten it wrong. No time to argue. Cure dispersal imminent. Must counteract sabotage. Stop me if you must. No. Not ready.
A long time ago, my father betrayed me in this place. His own son. He tried to kill me, so I had to kill him. Right over there. That's what the Genophage reduced us to. Animals. But you changed that today, Shepard.
Now we'll fight for our children, not against them. It's just a pity Morton had to die.
mean up on the tower?
Yes, that was the courage of the highest order, sacrificing himself so our children may live.
1,000 years from now, we'll probably be singing songs about him.
But you, Commander, we can thank you in person.
Tell the Turians I'll be deploying troops to Palavin immediately. And when you're ready to kick the Reapers off Earth, you let me know. The Krogan are back in business.
Goodbye, Commander.
What will you do now?
Spread the hope you've given us. Even now, there are clans gathering in the Kelphic Valley. I'll go speak to them and make sure this gift isn't squandered. Thank you for all that you've done. And know that Erdnot Bakara calls you a friend.
Hell of a thing you just pulled off, Commander. Curing the Genophage? I never thought I'd see the day.
Rex has agreed to help the Turians, Admiral. We should get their full support.
And the Salarians? How did you manage to get them on board?
Careful diplomacy.
Uh-huh. I don't think I want to know what that means. Doesn't matter. You're starting to put together a real alliance out there. Good work, Commander. Hackett, out.
Commander, Erdnot Rax has begun sending troops to Palavin. You kept your end of the bargain, and now I'll keep mine. The Turian hierarchy will stand with humanity against the Reapers.
I'm glad we can help each other out. It's the only way we're going to defeat the Reapers.
That much is certain. To that end, several dry dock ships are ready to help build the Crucible. Garrus will coordinate them.
Yes, sir.
And when the time comes to deploy it, the full measure of our fleet will be there for Earth. May the spirits watch over us all.
I'll start managing Turian support right away, Shepard. You must be exhausted. Morden dying, it can't be easy.
I'll sleep when I'm dead.
We both know you need a clear head to win a war. There's no room for mistakes here. You should catch some shut-eye. I'll make sure Joker doesn't launch any suicide missions.
Anything happens, you let me know. It's open.
Shepard, there's something you need to hear.
All right.
Is this a bad time?
Thinking of some friends who aren't around, thanks to this war.
That's thanks to the Reapers, not you. Are you thinking about anyone in particular?
Ashley, back on Vermeier. She gave her life stopping Sovereign. I wonder what she'd make of fighting a whole fleet of Reapers.
If I had to guess, Ashley would call it target practice.
Yeah. Sounds like her. Didn't you have something for me?
The Solarian Counselor has an urgent matter.
Let me guess. He called the comm room?
The Council must be taking the Crucible seriously. I'll see you downstairs.
Commander, I understand the issue of Krogan reinforcements to Palavin has been resolved to everyone's satisfaction.
I wouldn't say everyone, but it'll do.
I don't bother with specifics. They always disappoint. At any rate, I have a different problem in mind. I have concerns about humanity's representative, Counselor Udina. My agents have discovered that he's using his authority to move vast sums of money. For what purpose? We're not sure.
If Udina's dirty, it's best we get to the bottom of it fast.
Agreed. Come to the Citadel. We will review the evidence and discuss this in private. Valern out.
Commander, Admiral Hackett's available on VidCom.
Commander Shepard, something you need to talk about?
What's our state of readiness, Admiral?
I won't lie, Shepard. We're bogged down. Things aren't looking good in most sectors. We need to increase the tempo and chalk up some wins, otherwise, this won't end well for the human race. Or any race.
What about the extra help we've picked up along the way?
The Krogan and Turians have obviously been a big help. Erdnot Rex running the show is a bonus for us. And that female Krogan you rescued is rallying more support from the other clans. I'm glad you disabled that bomb on T'Chunka. We could have lost a lot of Krogan support as it is. We picked up some Turian troops.
Good to hear. How about the Solarians?
They've committed a fleet. I still don't know how you manage that, given their views on the Genophage cure.
What about Arya's mercenaries?
Arya T'Lok, there's someone I never thought we'd be in bed with. The Blood Pack will be useful. And violent. Mostly Vorchai here. We'll put the Blue Suns to good use. Intel says Darnar Vosk is bringing his men, and that they're gunning for a fight. The Eclipse are providing troops and mechs. When we find a Reaper soft spot, they'll help us hit it. Don't want to know how you got Arya's cooperation, but whatever you did, it was worth it.
Do you know how the other races are doing against the Reapers?
Believe it or not, the Turians and Krogan actually seem to be getting along. Erdnot Rex has deployed troops, and they're giving the Reapers a moment of pause. The Solarians are still hanging on to Sirkesh, but the Reapers are starting to breathe down their necks, too.
What about the Asari?
They have to be feeling the heat. The Reapers are moving fast with the obvious intent of taking Thessia. Interestingly, the Reapers are leaving Parnak alone. It's the Yogg homeworld.
Can't say that I blame them. Yogg have teeth.
Well, if we lose this war, it might be them running the next cycle. It's easy to forget the Reapers don't destroy every species.
Just the ones who can threaten them. Any word on the Volus and Alcor?
The Turians and the Krogan sent forces to the Volus homeworld, Irun. It might not be enough, but at least they've got Reaper forces bogged down in a nasty ground war. As for Alcor, they're still in the fight, though our projections show the Reapers encroaching on their territory soon.
What happened to the Batarians?
Never stood a chance, hit by the Reapers straight out of the gate. And without any allies to call on, I think the Batarians are history.
Have we heard anything from the Quarians or Geth?
Something might be brewing near the Geth border, but our intel is sketchy. News is getting harder to come by as things get worse.
How do you see us winning this war, Admiral?
By making you the tip of the spear.
I'm flattered, but the Normandy's just one ship.
And a fast one. You can move quickly, hit a target, and leave before the enemy has time to react.
It's an advantage, but can it win a war?
It's the larger principle that matters. We'll never defeat the Reapers in a full frontal assault, Shepard. The battle against Sovereign 3 years ago took everything we had, and that was just one Reaper.
I haven't forgotten.
So I'll find their soft spots, avoid them where they're strong, and hit them where they're not. And when I find gaps in the armor, I'll hammer them with every soldier, ship, and bullet we've got.
How long can we keep that up?
As long as it takes. The reality is, Shepard, everything I'm doing is a delaying action for you. I'm buying us time, keeping us in the game, while you gather what we need for the Crucible. So keep at it.
Nothing more, sir.
Keep me posted. Hack it out.
Taking down the Reaper?
Man, I wish I could have been there.
I'm just glad the diplomats are off the ship. A Krogan and a Turian in the same room is a fight waiting to happen.
Commander, Admiral Hackett has requested your help with a Cerberus fighter base on Navaria. The Turians have given us top-level access to their combat data. Their ships are already moving in to help the Alliance fleet. You actually secured a Krogan-Turian alliance. It's one thing to hear about Commander Shepard. It's another to see him in action. Any sign of life?
The Reaper destroyed by the Thresher Maw appears to be completely inert, Doctor. We would need to send in teams to be sure.
Out of the question. Tell the Krogan to stay away. Rex knows what he's doing, but can he keep the Krogan in check? Or will this be the start of another Krogan Empire? Eve's organizing the female Krogan. She reminds me of some of the more formidable matriarchs I've known. The Krogan won't let themselves fall by the wayside again. Not like they did after the rebellions. We'll have to get used to them having a bigger part in the galaxy. I hope the Krogan live up to their ancient legacy, and for the better. Good to see you again, Shepard.
Just reviewing some charts.
What are you up to now?
I'm uploading data on the destroyed Reaper to the Turians. They are investigating possible Reaper structural weakness. Our data says Reaper capital ships such as Sovereign are of unique design. However, smaller Reaper destroyers bear similarities.
That one was small?
Relatively, yes. Ground attack ships are only 160 meters in height. Sovereign was approximately 2 kilometers.
Well, keep talking to the Turians. If there's a chink in the Reaper's armor, we all need to know it.
Hello, Shepard.
Genophage cure, huh? This beats the hell out of reporting on the Milgrim City Council.
I don't think I've heard of Milgrim. Which planet is that again?
Beckenstein. It's right next door to the Citadel. I'm a colony kid. Commander, got a minute?
What do you want to know?
You've just implemented a cure for the Genophage. Millions of Krogan will start fighting the Reapers. What do you say to people who think humanity is starting another Rachni War and Krogan rebellions?
It's easy to remember the worst of Krogan history, but you also need to remember the best.
Meaning?
The Krogan were heroes once, and they want to be heroes again. We're giving them that chance.
Are you aware that Clan Erdnot is already petitioning the Council for an embassy and rights to a colony world?
The Krogan are coming to the aid of a Council homeworld. That's more than a lot of species can say. I help them get the Genophage cure. Anything more is between the Council and the Krogan.
There it is, straight from Commander Shepard. Until tomorrow, this is Diana Allers. Good night and stay strong. Okay, I'll cut that together with the rest of the segment and send it to Command for approval. Commander.
Nothing to report, Commander.
My board is green.
Commander.
You settling in, Javik?
I believe some of the crew wishes to be my friend. That is not my purpose here. Also, I find I need to wash my hands. The residue of the ship is strong.
How so?
I have been exploring. There are traces of those who lived on the Normandy before. I detected a human female. Her genetic structure was unnatural, as if artificially created.
Sounds like Miranda.
And a Drell. There was illness in him.
Thane.
And a Krogan who lived in these quarters. He was undergoing a metamorphosis. His memories were confused, not organic to his mind. There was great confusion and turmoil.
I still can't wrap my head around that. Reading information like you do.
For my people, it was as natural as breathing.
Evolution's an amazing force.
Our scientists believed it was the only force in the galaxy that mattered. They called it the cosmic imperative. The strong flourished. The weak perished. The governments of your cycle seem concerned with ensuring the survival of all.
Was this imperative just your scientists' opinion? Or did they prove something we don't know?
The universe had already proven it. They only had to look around.
And saw what exactly?
Extinction is the rule of law in the cosmos, the natural order of things. The weakest species are doomed.
It's the duty of the strong to protect the weak. Otherwise, we'd have anarchy.
But those who had nothing to offer would be eliminated.
So conflict should be a way of life?
Evolution demands it. The strong grow stronger by dominating the weak. It is for the greater good of all. Though I do not think your Asari approves of my beliefs.
Liara? I think she just had a different idea about what Protheans were like.
We are all a product of our time. Had I been born in this cycle, perhaps I would be the noble scholar she wishes me to be.
You think you'd like that? It's a whole different line of work.
I wouldn't know. Living a life of constant war, taking life in every battle.
I see how it could be tough to see outside the box.
It is the only box I have known. It shapes me, as stone is shaped by the one who carves it. The stone has no choice in the form it will take. You and I, Commander, war is our sculptor, and we are prisoners to its design.
Maybe not much longer. We win this, and we'll both be set free.
You have killed a Reaper. I would like to have seen it. No matter. There will be more.
Plenty more.
Yes, a difficult fight remains. In your position, I would have offered the Salarian leader a deal.
Oh?
You only had to make the Krogan believe you cured their disease. They are too stupid to know the difference. The Salarians would have been grateful and rewarded you. Both would have served you at the same time. Morality and friendship do not matter now. Your allies are simply resources to use against the Reapers. I am detecting an air of deception about you, Commander. The mind may lie, but the body cannot. If you have done as I suspect, your commitment to victory is beyond reproach. If the Krogan seek retribution for the past, do not waste time on sterility plagues. Destroy them where they stand. In the meantime, they are useful cannon fodder against the Reapers. Do not care what others think. Do what you must. Do not care what others think.
All right, my turn. What's the first order an Alliance commander gives at the start of combat?
I give up.
Correct.
All right, big guy. What do you call it when a Turian gets killed by a horrible spiky monster?
A friendly fire. Come on, that one goes back to Shang-Chi.
How you gotta respect the classics?
How many humans does it take to activate a dormant mass relay?
602. 600 to vote on it, one to ask the Asari for technical help, and one to request a seat on the council afterward. How do you know when a Turian's out of ammo?
He switches to the stick up his ass as a backup weapon. Why does the Alliance hire pilots with brittle bone disease?
You're shitting me! The Turian military has one about me?
Oh, absolutely. I heard it myself from a private back on Palavin.
All right, why does the Alliance hire pilots with brittle bone disease?
So their Marines can beat someone in hand-to-hand drills.
Damn, you need to tell James that one. Hey, what's the hardest part about treating a Turian who took a rocket to one side of his face?
Figuring out which side took the rocket.
Never thought I'd see the Krogan and the Turians team up. Even the Reapers have to be a little nervous about pissing them off.
I'd say more than a little.
I'm sorry about Morden.
Had to be done.
He'll have a hell of a tombstone. Cured the genophage, with a little asterisk, and then at the bottom it'll say, which he also created.
I always thought he was crazy. Useful, but crazy. Then he gives up his own life.
To save the Krogan. Doesn't do much to disprove the crazy theory, huh?
I guess not. But he was one of ours.
So now that we got the Krogan and the Turians, what now?
The Krogan help us turn the tide on Palavin. They can shoot at something useful for a change.
Dig till we hit daylight, huh? Works for me.
So how does it feel knowing Krogan will be singing songs about you until the end of time? I'd think it would be an honor.
To be honest, I did it so the Krogan would help your people.
And believe me, it won't be forgotten.
I'm sure it won't.
You okay? You don't need to worry. Our fleets will be there for Earth. I'll make sure of it.
I know you will.
And let's hope Rex keeps running the show on T'Chanka. Maybe we should hire a food taster for him. Imagine the carnage if some young, hot-headed Krogan took over.
We'll just have to see what happens.
I know. It's a chance we have to take, but I have to say, if it wasn't my own world that needed the help, I might have looked for a way out.
That would have been tough to live with, tricking an entire species like that.
I'm not saying you wouldn't need ice in your veins, but I doubt Morden would have gone along with it.
No. He wouldn't.
Commander?
I wonder where all the Krogan will live now. I've never seen what you'd call a house on T'Chanka. I wonder where all the Krogan will live. Thank you.